So how to write the code. And my suggestion is for the strategy, or what I'm showing you here is, so we use two loops. So we have one inner loop. And this inner loop, this generates one symbol. So this could be either the zero symbol, which is a small amplitude, or it's the one symbol, which is a large amplitude. And this is here our symbol duration t. And then this at f0.1, so that we have that this lasts here exactly 10 samples. Remember, this is in terms of samples a definition. And so that's our inner loop. Oops. That's our inner loop. And then we have an outer loop. Outer loop that's that provides provide the data, or the bits in this case here. So that's a general concept we're also using for the other modulation schemes, like phase and frequency modulation. So let's implement this quickly. So let's bring back octave here. So let's define our carrier frequency. So remember, this is, let's call this here just f, and we call this 0.1 in normalized frequencies. It has no dimension. And then we have here the t symbol. Let's say we have a length of 20, so that this means we're getting two revolutions of that. And then let's say, so then the total runtime of this is then t total of number of samples is the length of our bit stream multiplied by our length of our symbol. That's spelled wrong. So this gives us a total time. And so now the only thing what we need to do is now is creating these two nested loops. So remember, the first loop, we just looping through the bit stream, yeah. So from one to length of the bit stream, yeah. So with this, we are working through our Pac-Man one by one. And then, so if the bit stream of this index number is 1, then we say, okay, the amplitude is 1, and so large in this case, and the amplitude is small if this is 0. And so now we have decided if the symbol at this point, if the symbol is large or small. And so now we just need to generate the symbol in the other loop here. Let's just quickly go back here just to have a look where this, I've already taken this away. So let's quickly have a look here. So now I've have the outer loop here that provides the data bits, and I should say also in this case here already the amplitude. And so now I just need to create this waveform. So let's bring octave back, and so now let's just generate here the waveform by running from 1 to t symbol. So that's a length of one symbol. And so now let's say am signal of, so now we need another variable here, t equals cosine of 2 pi multiplied by f, this is here our carrier frequency, and multiplied by the time, and then we multiply this by the amplitude, and then we are ending this loop. So this loop creates us one symbol, and then we're ending this loop here, and this loop here, this is here the end of the for loop, which is up here. So now we need to define the t here. So t is our overall index variable, which is counting through the wave. So we're setting this here to 1. And we need to increment it here. Oh. So let's see if this works. If I type in am, okay, I've got a spelling mistake. Amplitude, okay, let's save that. Okay, so that's looking good. So let's plot am signal. Let's see what we are getting out here. Okay, excellent. So now we see our AM signal here, which is generated from our bitstream. So we've got the high amplitude and the low amplitude, and this is nicely switching between that. So now the next step is obviously to demodulate this and to see if we're getting our Pac-Man back.